As a lawyer, you could please explain to us what actually happens on the ground to those people who have been dealing with the NRC and Assam on one hand, basically saying we are Indian citizens, we need to be on the National Register for Citizens, but who found themselves excluded from the list. Now, how can you get up tomorrow and say, bhai, I was religiously persecuted in Pakistan or Bangladesh, isliye mujhe Citizenship Amendment Bill ke andar give me citizenship. So how is this going to actually work? It's a crazy contradiction.
It's not going to work.
That's what I'm asking. I'm asking legally, from a legal point.
First of all, it's total chaos. First of all, you have 20 lakh persons who are declared not Indian. Now, 20 lakh persons have become stateless. No country accepts them. India says, you're not mine. 20 lakh people are stateless, which means according to the UN Statelessness Convention, they can't be arrested. They can't be denied basic rights. So what are you going to do with them? Has the government thought before engaging in such a stupid exercise, which breaks the country, tears the country apart, what will you do with 20 lakhs? And the government says, we'll take their land, we'll take their shops. You can't do that. You're building detention centers. You can't do that. Therefore, first of all, it is a mindless exercise which has no end. And if you ask the BJP, what will you do with these people now that you know that they are there? They have no answer. And in many television debates, they say, we'll come to it when the time comes. We'll decide after they determine 20 lakh people. That's the first thing. Secondly, if you're making the point, as they do, that it's not religion, but it's discrimination, then some of the panelists made a correct point. Then what about the Ahmadiyyas from Pakistan? What about the Hazaras from Afghanistan? What about the bloggers who are atheists? That's also a kind of non-religion. The bloggers from Bangladesh who are being persecuted. And of course, she made the point of the Sri Lankan Tamil. So it's not the persecution that they are concerned with, really. There's some kind of invidious discrimination against Muslims per se. And that's the truth of the matter they must face.
But Sangeeta, how are these fears playing out on the ground in terms of the chaos again that we speak of? Now, if you are somebody who's not on the NRC, how are you going to say now that, you know, after saying that you are an Indian, suddenly turn around and say that you're not?
Actually, it is actually going to make a lot of Bengali Hindus first Bangladeshis, because when you and then give them citizenship, you know, if at all. So my whole thing is that you are actually applying in the NRC saying that I came to this state before the birth of Bangladesh. So now you are saying that you are persecuted in a country where you are actually, you've already declared that you actually don't belong to that country. So I don't know how that is going to play out. But the other thing is also that if you see it from the NRC point of view, the post-NRC the procedures, that means only perhaps the Muslims will have to now go through that whole process of foreigners tribunal. That is one thing. And then the other thing is also this, and there are some amount of tribals, Assamese, you know, they're there. So they will not be able to take benefit of that. So they will also have to go through this. And then the other thing is, you know, when you are talking about this partition narrative, you are trying to take this back to partition narrative, you are actually also denying why Bangladesh was formed. Bangladesh, in a way, was actually rejection of the religious, you know, the point that the country was divided. So it got united, you know, on the basis of a language and other cultural identity. So when you go back to this, you know, to trying to take the point back to partition, you are actually also questioning the existence of the locus standi of Bangladesh as a country. And the other thing is also, Bangladesh is one of the most friendliest nations that we have now today as neighbors. So you are actually also, government of India is also actually accusing Bangladesh that we are making your citizens into our country because you've not been able to protect them.
They're not going to take them back.